The proposed job cuts are across the board. They include 59 teachers, 24 custodians, 3 maintenance workers, 3 secretaries, 1 assistant principal, a guidance counselor, and an executive director. In all, 112 jobs hang in the balance and could be gone the next school year.
Volunteers are taught to battle the flames from low on the ground. In most cases, when a house is burning, the fire and smoke travels 3 feet and above.
Well, this is the parking lot where it all happened. A Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office spokeswoman says that there was a deputy here. He was on duty, was not wearing a uniform, but they say he was wearing a badge. It didn't take long for Boynton Beach Police to crack this case wide open. The victims and witnesses got a good look at the criminals and their getaway car. They also gave cops a partial tag number. Within an hour, Boynton Beach Police had 2 arrests. The beach is open again, but very few people are going in the water. And for the people who are going in the water, they are not going very far. For police, it is war on the streets. They say with 160 known gangs in Palm Beach County, the drug game is only scratching the surface. But Spiracco didn't stop there. Neighbors say he started to fire even more rounds into their yard.
Run, but you can't hide. Is this another case of Big Brother watching? You betcha. Whether it's a highway, state road, or even a local street, the GPS system can tell where you are and whether or not you're speeding.
But census workers are finding out it is not easy. Some are being turned away at the door. For the last year and a half, people who live on Southeast Helen Terrace have complained about burglaries happening in their neighborhood. Well, guess what? It happened again this morning. But this time, the tables were turned on the criminals. Renee Grandlund is a no-nonsense type of woman who refused to let burglars get away with her belongings.
Because I'm tired of people thinking that they can rob and take from people. It's called go to work.
Grandlund says when she arrived home Wednesday morning, someone was sitting in a car in her driveway. She says as he drove away, she spotted 3 men with pillowcases running away from her home.
They were dropping all my stuff. They broke my windows. They ransacked my house. Took my father's war medals. They had no choice but to come out this way and run that way. They're just taking off like jackrabbits, hopping over fences, whatever, and they're carrying my stuff, and I'm yelling at them, give me back my stuff. They don't belong to you.
Grandlund followed what she believed was the getaway car. She also felt she needed to get her neighbor's attention.
And all the neighbors came out dialing 911 on their cell phones. They knew. It's like immediately.
Grandlund called 911 too and told the dispatcher,
I'm being robbed. We have the robbers on our street. Please send police.
Within minutes, police were on scene, located the car, and arrested 4 men.
Watch your step, watch your heads.
Detectives say 2 of the men confessed that they traveled to the area to commit burglaries. Investigators believe they are part of a group called the Pillowcase Burglars.
We believe that this is a fairly sizable group that have been quite active in communities from Miami to South Carolina along I-95.
They went through all my father's belonging and war medals.
Grandlund says the thieves grabbed cash, jewelry, her bank account information, and her laptop.
They just came to the wrong house, let's just say that.
Police say that these men are from the Broward County area. They say the message is loud and clear. They are looking for other people, and they hope to add more arrest to these crimes. Reporting live in Stewart, Ted White, WPBF 25 News. It didn't take long for Boynton Beach Police to crack this case wide open. The victims and witnesses got a good look at the criminals and their getaway car. They also gave cops a partial tag number. Within an hour, Boynton Beach Police had 2 arrests. The crime outside this Boynton Beach Walmart took seconds.
Oh my God.
And turned an elderly couple's world upside down. Surveillance cameras captured the real-life drama late Tuesday night. 81-year-old Edward Youngblood and his wife Sherry had just finished grocery shopping. The man with the baseball cap and shorts follows them out the door, and a few seconds later, he makes his move. He grabs the woman's purse and runs to a silver car that pulls up. The victims run after him, but the car takes off. The door hits the husband, and he falls down.
It's the upbringing. I don't care what you say. It's the way they're upbrought not to respect their elders. I was brought up, I would never think of doing anything like that when I was a teenager, and even if I went home, I got my butt kicked by my dad.
Before the car sped away, Youngblood even hit the car with his cane. His fall to the ground looks painful, but he was not seriously hurt.
I feel like you just have to be aware that what's around you constantly, you know, and I'm like the whole people that they're getting now. If I have a cane, I'll go after them too.
Someone called 911. The car got away, but not for long. An officer spotted the vehicle down the street and held the man and woman at gunpoint until other units arrived. Police arrested 26-year-old Brandon Grace. The victims told detectives he was standing behind them in line and was looking at the purse.
And Amy's here on a charge of robbery.
They arrested Amy Kaufman, too. Police say the 32-year-old was behind the wheel.
But due to the fact the age of this victim, I'm asking for 15 on each count for a total of 30.
Yeah, well, I try to put my pocketbook over my shoulder, and I try to watch it when I go to stores, and I always check my car when I get back in.
My husband is not with me. I try to park as close to the door as possible, and I don't do it at night, yeah. Ever.
Gracie and Kaufman both face two felony charges each. Gracie was not in court today. We did reach the victims. They did not want to talk on camera. However, I reached them by phone. They say they should be okay. However, they are very angry with the suspects involved. We're live at Boynton Beach. Ted White, WPBF 25 News.
Hi there. It was a pretty good turnout considering. And Meredith, I might as well get it out of the way. The fireworks ended with a bang. And while the rain kept a lot of people away, others came down here and prepared to do battle with the elements. And they did their best to make sure they had a good time with all the festivities.
The rain is not going to dampen our fun tonight.
In downtown West Palm Beach, many people who looked forward to all that 4th on Flagler offers didn't let the wet weather rain on their parade.
I like fireworks because they pop up the sky.
Most tried to dodge the raindrops, but it wasn't easy.
We hung out under an awning, just people watching, having a good time.
Well, it's not raining so hard, so that's all right. It's better than being hot and in blazing sun.
There was food, games for the young and youngest at heart. DJs and music to soothe the soul.
It's really a good thing for me to come here with them so they can experience what's going on in 4th of July.
We love everything so far. The kids having fun. That's all it's about. We're just here for the kids to have fun.
I like them because they pop up the sky.
Hold on. We'll get to the big show in a moment.
Cheers.
Happy 4th.
Forget driving downtown. Sandy Chin and John Ricozzi parked their boat along the dock at the new and improved waterfront.
Peace of mind to have the boat tied off to the dock rather than being out there on the hook.
I like them because they pop up the sky.
Okay, we're almost there. But first, West Palm Beach firefighters scaled down a high rise with Old Glory to make it official. Ah, the fireworks. 17 minutes of bim, bam, boom. And even though it rained again while the bombs burst in the air, most people didn't seem to mind.
But I like them because they pop up the sky.
Good evening, I'm Ted White. Thanks for joining us. Developing now, a 9-year-old boy is dead after his family's SUV flipped and caught fire this afternoon. It happened just before 2 on U.S. Highway 27 in South Bay. Police say bystanders did all they could do to save the boy. Along mile marker 59 in South Bay, Palm Beach County Sheriff's deputies gather information at a gruesome scene. Drowsy driving could be responsible for an accident that sent 4 people, including 2 young children, to the hospital. It happened just after 7 this morning at the intersection of Haverhill Road and 45th Street in West Palm Beach. 22-year-old Wade Harris told police he may have fallen asleep at the wheel and crashed into an oncoming car. A 2-year-old girl and 6-year-old boy in that oncoming car suffered broken bones. Harris and his passenger had minor injuries. Investigators say charges are likely. A car fire shut down parts of Donald Ross Road in Jupiter this afternoon. These photos were taken by WPBF 25's news viewer Troy Bone. It happened before 3:30 near Central Boulevard. We've learned it was a 2001 Volkswagen and it may have had a mechanical issue. No one was injured. An outpouring of support today for a Palm Beach County Sheriff's deputy injured in an accident. Cheryl Griffin made her first appearance before cameras today at a fundraiser in West Palm Beach. Her arm was amputated during a boating accident in June, and she is still recovering from her injuries. Today, family and friends held a motorcycle run and barbecue benefit to help Griffin with her medical costs.
And I'm glad that my best buddy is here, Melissa, who's sitting beside me. There are a lot of people here. It's very emotional.
A girl in Broward County wandered out of her home and drowned in her family's swimming pool. It happened around 8 last night in the 6500 block of Northwest 78th Drive. That's in Parkland. Authorities say Adriana Martinez, who would have been 2 next month, snuck out while her father was in the bathroom and her mother was sleeping. Adialana's father found her in the shallow end of the pool. He performed CPR, but it was too late. An early morning stabbing sent one person to the hospital and another to jail. It happened just after 4 in the 3200 block of McSherry Drive in Lake Worth. Police say two men got into an argument and the victim was stabbed several times. He was rushed to Delray Medical Center and is listed in serious condition tonight. So far, no formal charges have been filed against the suspect.